When a figure skater lands a jump, she lands with about 5 to 8 times her body weight in force. Those high magnitude forces are due to the fact that she's moving really quickly. She's landing from a height. She doesn't have time to absorb those forces through the body. So that force just gets transmitted straight from the ice up through her lower extremities, up to the back. When we look at the high-speed video, we can see not only how is the body absorbing the forces, but also how the body works to generate these forces.
A skater may do between 50 and 60 jumps on a day where they're preparing for competition. A lot of skaters, by the time they're 20, 30, 40, have double hip replacements from all the pounding and the damage. You just feel old, really young.
They have a lot of force that they're landing with over and over again, and this contributes to overuse injuries. So we've been designing a device that we can attach to a figure skate. It'll be unobtrusive to the skater, and it'll measure the impact forces on takeoff and landing.
This is really the first time that actual forces are measured on ice.
In the lab testing, we've been having the skater jump onto a force plate. This is really set up to get some baseline data initially.
We're collecting data from 3 different spots, in the front and the middle and on the back part of the skate. And that's what the 6 different lines are we see on the screen. Right here where the large lines are is where she actually impacts.
So we want to be able to measure forces as small as 6 pounds and as great as 1,000 pounds.
When someone jumps on the ice, those stanchions compress about 1/1,000,000th of an inch. So that's about 1/1,000th of the width of a human hair. So very, very small compressions.
It's a whole body workout.
You can see just how much strength it really takes to do the skill. When you do a figure skating jump landing, you always land on the toe and then rock back to the heel. That toe impact is not where the highest impacts are. You get a pretty high impact there, then you rock back to the heel, and that's where you get up to 5 to 8 times body weight. And that happens really quickly. It's within 50 to 125 milliseconds. Comparing that to running, where you land with maybe 2 to 3 times your body weight in each step you take, we can see that these magnitudes are really high. The skating boot provides very little protection. In general, coaches and skaters may not talk about landing forces all that often. It's just kind of a necessary evil. This is what happens. You know, you land a jump and you have these high magnitude forces. U.S. Figure Skating is really interested in this research because they want to be able to keep skaters healthy. They want to be able to keep their elite skaters performing at a high level and then keep skating safe as a sport for any participant.